Hello and welcome to another video by Vertical Attitude. This time we'll be fitting an external socket, both the normal TV and satellite cable. This is the box that it came in. So instead of putting this lead through the window each time, I'll have a socket on the side of the vehicle. I've already got a socket there with its normal TV, and I wanted one for the satellite separately. So that's the box. This is the kit. This is the unit that goes on outside. As you can see, it fits like this. Get these connectors, also a join between cables. If you need a longer stretch of cables, you can join them together. This is the cable that comes with it. It's a satellite cable and a normal TV type of cable, which I won't need to use because I've already got one connected up. So what I'll need to do is, I want to get the socket in, trace this to the present cable and just follow it through. Some of these, don't think I'll be needing those. I'll use cable ties underneath the vehicle because that's be the routing. So go to the vehicle now. I'll show you the present situation, and just as an overview, what I'm going to do. This is the vehicle. Here's the TV aerial socket currently in position. This obviously goes inside here. It comes inside the wall of the wardrobe. I need to take that cover off. And I know from previous things that I've done that the cable runs underneath and down through a hole there and underneath the vehicle. And I've got to get it to a TV connector there, comes through the side there. I suspect it comes up underneath there, so that cover has got to come off so I can route it through. A little bit of investigation required. I think I'll route the cable first, make sure I've got long enough so I can fit it outside on the new socket. Will be a little bit of drilling required outside, because obviously the new socket is a lot bigger. But like I said, I got this cable here, so that socket's there, so I've only got to do one routing of the satellite cable. At least when I get it done, I won't have to put the cable from the satellite dish through the window. So far managed to route the cable up through the top down there, down this area here. I managed to prise that away slightly. It's only a plastic clip thing, and so I've got it going all the way down there, coming out under the bed, as you can see. All I've got to do is find a hole or drill a hole to get it underneath the vehicle over to the wardrobe side and the new socket. So I'll press forward with that. I'll just cable tie this to other cables underneath the vehicle, and hopefully we'll be good to go. I've routed the cable down through the corner, cable tied it to other cables, drilled a hole through the floor to underneath. This hole I will seal up. I've had to move the ducts for the heating at the moment, but as a simple job, I shall just pop them back in and screw the connections to the side there. So hopefully now I'll go underneath the vehicle, cable tied to another cable route to the other side of the wardrobe, and once in there, drill another hole, bring the cable up,
and then install the brand new socket on the outside.
Managed to find a hole already underneath the wardrobe there, so I didn't have to do any drilling. So I brought the cable underneath there, it comes out there, that's a hole leading to the exterior socket. That came off with just two screws. Here it is, this unit here, two screws in it. You bring the front plate off and it releases the cable. So that was obviously in there, and there's the cable. So obviously now I've just got to put the new socket on and seal it up. Big hole like that, I shall seal it from the inside as well. Make sure it's watertight. To go in one screw hole that was already there. I'll now take this off. Put the back cover on. Seal it against water. I shall now drill these holes. Just looks like a bit of putty, really. Right, I'm going to attempt to screw this on. Bit awkward. Just pushing through the back foam seal. But I think we'll get it in there. Just twisting a little bit. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take that off. I'm just going to put my drill through the foam bits. See, it's not. I need a little bit of gap there so it goes through without twisting. Right, just try this again. Hopefully,
start here. Don't do the screws too tight because obviously it's just plastic. See immediately that these screws aren't long enough. I need to get longer screws so they go in a lot better. Just a little pain of you know what. Found some longer screws. Don't need this bit on at the moment. Looking at the instructions, it should lay like this. We'll try that. Job finished. Nice and tight. Need to seal the hole from the inside. Put all the bits back in. Seal any other holes that I've drilled. And
job will be complete. I hope you enjoyed watching.